Hello and welcome to 3D Nato. My name is Nato, and in today's video I'll show you how to animate the hands of a clock using drivers. Here you can see the clock model I used for this tutorial. It is a simple model that has 5 different parts: the clock body, a glass, the hour hand, the minute hand, and the second hand. For this tutorial, I'll use the animation workspace. Here we have almost everything we need to animate this clock, but I'm going to make some changes. The first thing is to change this viewport to the driver's editor. Just go to editor type and select drivers. Next is to change the dope sheet to timeline. Go to editor type and select timeline. Now divide the timeline and open the graph editor. Hover the mouse cursor on this border until a cross appears, then click and drag to divide it. Go to editor type and select graph editor. To finish the setup, let's change the frame rate. By default, Blender sets all scenes to 24 frames per second, but I'm going to set it to 30. Go to Output Properties and set frame rate to 30 frames per second. And on timeline, set start frame to 0 and press Shift plus left arrow to go to frame 0. Drivers are a way to control values of properties by means of a function or mathematical expression. As an example, the rotation of object 1 can be controlled by the scale of object 2. It is then said that the scale of object 2 drives the rotation of object 1. This means that we still need to manually create a base animation for one of the three hands, so the others can follow. I decided that it would be easier to animate the second hand and use it to drive the others. The second hand will drive the minute hand, and the minute hand will drive the hour hand. With the second hand selected, press K to insert a keyframe and select rotation. This will create a rotation keyframe on frame 0. As we are creating the second hand animation, we need to divide 360 degrees from the circle by 60 seconds, which will give us 6 degrees of rotation for every second. Go to frame 30, press R to rotate, Z to lock rotation on the Z axis, type minus 6 to rotate 6 degrees clockwise, enter to confirm, K to insert a keyframe, and select rotation. By default, Blender sets all keyframe interpolation to Bezier. But if you look closely at the second hand of a clock, you'll notice that it kind of jumps to the next second. To replicate that, we'll need to change the keyframe interpolation. Go to Timeline, press A to select both keyframes, T to open keyframe interpolation, and select Constant. This will set no interpolation between A and B, as it holds the value of A until B, meaning it will hold the first keyframe rotation from frame 0 to 29, and will rotate only at frame 30. This will create an almost perfect animation for the hand. But a better way to create a more realistic animation is to copy the first keyframe and move it to frame 25. Select the first keyframe, press Shift plus D to duplicate, and type 25 to place it at frame 25. Now select the last two keyframes, press T, and set interpolation to bounce. To finish the second hand animation, we're going to use modifiers. On Graph Editor, expand Object Transforms, select both X and Y Euler Rotation, and press X to delete. Select Z Euler Rotation, go to Modifiers, add a Cycles modifier, and set After Mode to repeat with Offset. This will repeat the animation, adding 6 degrees of rotation for every second. Here you can see the difference between 4 different keyframe interpolation methods: Bezier, Linear, Constant, and Constant with Bounce. Feel free to choose the method you prefer here. Now we can use drivers to animate the other two clock hands. Let's add the first driver. Select the minute hand, press N on viewport to show the sidebar, right mouse click on Z rotation, and select Add Driver. On Driver Editor, select the Z Rotation driver, go to the Drivers tab, and set Type to Scripted Expression. Now we need to set a variable for this driver. Here you can see this variable is called var. On Object, select the second hand. On Type, set Z Rotation. On Mode, set Auto Euler. And on Space, set to WorkSpace. Now this variable var is using the Z rotation of the second hand. If we press the spacebar, we can see that the mini hand will follow whatever the second hand is doing. This is because the expression is adding 0 to the variable var. To fix this and make the minute hand rotate as it should be, we're going to use math. The math is simple. For every full 360 degrees turn of a second hand, we need to add 1 minute. So as the clock has 60 minutes, the minute hand needs to rotate 60 times lower than the second hand. To do this, go to expression and type var divided by 60. This will divide the variable we created before by 60. To make sure it's working, go to frame 1800 and check the minute hand Z rotation. It should be 6 degrees or 1 minute on the clock. Let's add the second driver. Select the hour hand, right mouse click on Z rotation, and select add driver. On driver editor, select the Z rotation driver, go to the drivers tab, and set type to scripted expression. On object, select the minute hand. On type, set Z rotation. On mode, set auto Euler. And on space, set to word space. The math is simple. For every full 360 degrees turn of the minute hand, we need to add 1 hour. So as the clock has 12 hours, the hour hand needs to rotate 12 times lower than the minute hand. To do this, go to expression and type var divided by 12. This will divide the variable we created before by 12. To make sure it's working, go to frame 108,000 and check the hour hand Z rotation. It should be 30 degrees or 1 hour on the clock. Now we need to parent all objects to the clock body. This will allow us to move and rotate the clock without messing the animation. Now we need to assign the parent. In this case here, the clock body. If you select them on 3D viewport, select the clock body last. But if you select them on view layer, like I'm doing here, select the clock body first. Just notice that the parent will always be the light orange object. On 3D viewport, press Ctrl plus P to set parent to and select object. Now if you move or rotate the clock body, the clock glass and all hands will follow. A simple way I found to change the hour is to select the second hand and on graph editor, add a noise modifier. Set all values to 0 and to change the hour, increase or decrease the strength value. And there you have it, a fully animated clock by creating only 2 keyframes, or 3 if you use the bounce method. If you're still here, it means you are liking the content of this channel. I really want to thank you for spending your time with me learning some basic Blender. I hope you have enjoyed as much as I have making it. So please, consider subscribing to the channel, like the video, share it, and leave a comment. Thanks a lot for watching, and see you on the next one. Bye bye.